All right, hello again, YouTube. Man, we just keep going with the videos here. This video is going to be about three gaming-related thingies, I guess. The first will be about the PlayStation Classic. The second will be about the Pat the NES Punk sort of riding on the coattails of Review Tech USA's video about their commentary, Pat the NES Punk and Ian. I think the guy's name is Ian or whatever, on this show that they have talking, you know, shut the fuck up to the people who were complaining about the Diablo Immortal thing and saying that people are entitled babies. And then the last thing I'm going to be yammering on about is this brand new article I just saw on Reddit talking about Nintendo wins $12 million lawsuit against ROM sites run by a married couple. So let's get into the first one, and this one is inspired by Metal Jesus Rocks, but I've seen this everywhere. Everyone's talking about the PlayStation Classic, and, you know, I have, like, four old PS1s. I managed to get them for a pretty decent price, and, you know, at one time or another in the last couple of years, these things have been pretty much being given away. Nobody wants the PS1, sadly, you know, and funny enough, the PS1 was one of the original sort of holdouts when I was thrifting. It was one, I shouldn't say the original, it was one of the last fucking things, you know, in gaming that I started to sort of see people dumping at the thrift stores. Like, as I said, it seemed like at some point, sadly, and I was very sad by this, you know, nobody wanted the PS1. Everybody moved on, seemingly, to the PS2 and PS3, and now, of course, the PS4. And the PS1 has been with us for quite some time now. So it's, you know, now Sony is trying to come out with this PS1 Classic, which I think, I will say right off the bat that I think it's a fucking awesome idea. The problem is that, and Metal Jesus goes into this, is that a lot of people are disappointed with the games that they chose, among other things, that, you know, previously they had only really, you know, sort of announced, I think it was about six games or so, and then they released the rest of the announcement saying that there's going to be a total of 20 games, and, you know, here's the layout, or, you know, the games we're releasing with the console. And it seems like it took a lot of people off guard. People were upset, some people were pissed, some people were disappointed, and, you know, in Metal Jesus Rock's case, you know, Metal Jesus Rock's on YouTube. I recommend watching his channel. I love his channel as well. I mean, this is not a critique against him. And he said he canceled his pre-order. I don't pre-order things anyway. It doesn't really fucking matter to me. If I see it on the shelf and I buy it, that's different. And I will say right off the bat too, that the pricing, you know, people have been bitching about the price. Now, that's the thing that caught me off guard the most about the PS1 Mini, PS1 Classic, is that people were complaining about the price. I was really shocked by that. And I'll tell you why. You know, Nintendo went ahead and released the NES Classic for, I think it was something like $80. Now, I may be mistaken, because up here in Canada, it was $100. And they still have it for sale now for $100. And then the Nintendo SNES, the Super Nintendo Classic, was also released. But that was a little more. That was, I think, something like $100-something here. I don't know what it went for in the States. I never checked up, and I never bought either of them, to be honest with you. I mean, I think they're, again, great ideas. And I'll get into something a little later on about this kind of thing, hopefully, if I fucking remember. And maybe I'll try to include that in the video. But otherwise, I'm trying to move on with all these things so you guys can get on with your day. Kind of a threefer in this video. But as I say, the Classic, the PS1 Classic, I think is, as I said, you know, a fantastic idea. And I think, you know, the titles that Sony has chosen, I think, are, you know, not all of them are going to be strong titles. But I think that the ones that they did choose, you know, there's some strong ones in there, like, the, you know, Final Fantasy VII, you've got Resident Evil, you got Twisted Metal, you know, and what the hell was the other one? There was another pretty good title in there. I mean, you know, you got, like, some of the fighting games. And again, people were kind of bitching, you know, and I'm just sort of like, well, wait a minute, you know, Nintendo released 20 titles on the Nintendo Classic, and then they released, I think, another 20 or so on the SNES. And, you know, first of all, my biggest gripe with people complaining is that, and I mean, I feel like I'm sort of having to stick up for Sony, even though I will, first off the hop, say I do have the PS1 and the PS2, and I've had the PS3, and I have a broken PS3. I did not get into the, you know, PS3 that much. I didn't like the PS3, and I am not into the PS4. I have not yet got into the current gen at all. So I'm by no means a fanboy, and fanboying to sort of protect Sony. I mean, Sony has done a lot of nefarious shit in the past. Don't be the first one to call it out. But what I will say is that, as I said, the pricing I find to be in line with, if you look at the simplicity of the Nintendo Classic and you look at the simplicity of the SNES Classic, I mean, you know, the games for those systems are, you know, so small. I mean, if you look at the ROMs, they're like 4 megs, 6 megs, 8 megs, something like that. For the Nintendo, the original Classic, you know, those games are only like 600 kilobytes or like a meg. So, you know, first of all, they don't need that much memory. Secondly, there was no analog sticks on either of them. And, you know, and then people criticized Sony for not including the analog sticks for the PS1 Classic's release. And I thought to myself, well, you know, hey, yeah, you know, I would have liked to see the analog sticks myself. But then immediately I thought, well, how much would it have cost them to manufacture the controllers? And I know historically, Sony has not, you know, with the wired controllers, they were pricey, man. Like, they were not cheap controllers. And I think it owed to the analog sticks that, you know, though they were not like the dog, I call it the dog bone, the original one, you know, that was purely, I guess, digital. Maybe you would call it digital. There was no analog sticks. But of course, we remember that back to the original release of the PS1, there were no analog sticks. And I didn't get into the PS1 until very, very late, actually, you know, fucking like a decade after it was released. I mean, way beyond when, I mean, I think I got into it after PS2, if I remember correctly. I never had a PS1 back in the day. So, you know, people griping about, you know, A, that there's no analog sticks, and then B, that the game selection is kind of shit. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know that I agree with that, especially for $100. And you know damn well that these things are going to be hacked. So I think that, you know, I think it's a decent value for $100. Now, granted, that's $100 US. So up here in Canada, I can only imagine what the fuck it's gonna pay, you know, go for, probably $120 or so. We always get fucked on the exchange. So, you know, it's one of those things where, I mean, I've already got a stack of PS1s because, as I just said, people were getting rid of these fucking things, and I, you know, was happy to take it off people's hands. You know, like, I'm talking like $10 a piece or less. Mind you, that's just the console. When you gotta buy memory cards, some people are still asking $5 to $10. If you want to get controllers, especially the analog ones, those are going for $5 to $10 a piece. And I'm talking at the thrift stores too. The thrift stores don't, you know, they've got wise to the fact that people are reselling this shit. I'm just there to collect, and so they've gone ahead and you know, up the price. I used to be able to get this stuff for like $4. You know, the games too. I'm talking NES games, SNES games, Genesis games. You don't see that shit anymore because the resellers have fucking pretty much raided thrift stores on masse, and I just, you know, I never see this shit on the shelves ever. I don't even see PS1 stuff on the shelves anymore. So with that said, I think Sony's offering is strong. That's my opinion. Take it or leave it. I mean, I'm just saying that, you know, I don't know what people are bitching about, because A, 20 PS1 games is going to come out to something like at least 10 gigs. But you have to remember that some of these games are multi-disc, like Final Fantasy VII, I have two copies of that, is 3 discs each. So 3 discs times about, what was it, 700 meg per disc. CDs back in the day were, I think PS1 uses CDs, some shit like that, some variant. I don't think DVD was out until the PS2 era. So, because I mean, that's what I bought it for, the PS2, but that's another thing altogether. So 700 meg times 3, that's, you know, well over, what, 2 gigs, right? It's about 2 gigs just for fucking Final Fantasy VII. And 2 gigs, you could fit the entire, you know, fucking NES collection, right? And same with SNES. 2 gigs is more than ample for, and that's just the storage for both of those consoles. You could probably fit both fucking consoles' releases, those 40 games between the two consoles, on 2 gigs. And now, granted, memory these days is not super expensive, so I'm not going to say that, oh, fuck, it's such a big expense. But when you think about the cost of the controllers, the plastics, the dies, and the console itself, I mean, they're going to have to cheap out somewhere, and it's going to definitely end up being in the game titles. So I think that the hardware itself, I'm assuming it's going to be running through emulation. So even that by itself, I mean, you get two controllers, that's another thing, because the original NES Classic, they only gave you one, the fuckers. And Nintendo was so cheap that they didn't even put a proper fucking length of cord. I know that people were bitching about, you know, it's like a 2-foot cord or some bullshit. Grab some water. So again, I find it was hilarious when people were bitching about the price, and I'm like, well, wait a minute. Nintendo got away with offering that pile of shit Nintendo Classic, which again, it's fun, and I mean, I'm not going to say it's a piece of shit. It's just that, relatively speaking, you have to think about the hardware that you're getting. I mean, the controller, relatively, like, fucking, how many buttons are on the original PS1 controller without analog sticks? Quite a few, right? And then you look at the NES controller, it's only got like, what, 5 buttons? Right? Well, what the fuck? You know, how do people not make that connection? And that's before you get into the size of the games and into 3D and the processing power required. I mean, how do you not see that it's going to be more money? Now, again, going back to the library that the PS1 Classic is being launched with, I mean, obviously they're not going to be able to fucking kick it out of the park with like every fucking game every, you know, ever released. There's like 1,000 games on the PS1. And second to that, these first-party titles and then second-party titles and, you know, the AAA titles that are, you know, not owned by Sony that they're going to have to get licensing for, I mean, obviously it's going to add to the price, guys. How the fuck are people thinking that they're going to release a full-on console? Keeping in mind, of course, back in the day when you bought the PS1 by itself, it didn't come with any fucking games. So what are you bitching about? I don't get it. I'm so fucking, like, I don't get it. Like, of all the things I'll bitch about, I'll never bitch about shit like that because I think to myself, wait a minute. They're including the fucking games. And not only are they including games, they're including 20 games. 20 decent games. You know, they're not I mean, some of them are fucking throwaway. Let's be real here. Like that block game. What the fuck is even, what even is that? You know, that's obviously that's a buffer game. But some of the titles that they're offering, I think even the 5 I would be okay with. Now, I mean, I'm obviously surprised that they didn't introduce like or include Gran Turismo, or what was he saying? What the hell is... Oh, for fuck's sake, I can't remember his name. The Spyro... Not Spyro. Fuck. What's his name? The original, like, mascot for the system. Crash Bandicoot. I'm surprised they didn't put that on there. And people could have, like, oh, Silent... He said Silent Hill. They're never gonna put fucking Silent Hill from Konami or Konami on the fucking system as a pack-in. You know, Konami would never go for that. And again, you have to go back to the licensing terms that they might have had at the time of release, which explains maybe why it's on the PSN network. You know, at some point, a lot of these PS1 titles found their way onto the network. Some of them have never been ported and never been relicensed. So I'd have to assume that the original licensing only covered the original release of the game back in the fucking, what, 90s? Like, Jesus, we're going way the fuck back, right? How the hell are you going to keep trying to, you know, you're going to come out 20 years later with a new console of a remake and then try to re-release this shit with the same licensing? That's not going to work. You're going to get sued up your ass. So Sony would get fucked in that deal. And so, again, I mean, I'm going on and on about this, but and I'm trying to still talk about two other topics, so I guess I'm going to have to break this up into two videos. But for the sake of argument, I think that the PS1 release is strong. I think that the Classic is going to It could potentially do well if people look at it the way, kind of the way I'm looking at it. And the way I'm looking at it is like, okay, you know, if you didn't have a fucking PS1 to begin with, it's a good idea to get one, right? Because you get the value of the games included. It's $100. If you try to buy this shit, you know, separately, you go in the open market, you try to buy Final Fantasy VII, for example, that game is at least $30 up here by itself. You buy you know, 2 controllers, that's going to be $10 or $20. You buy the console itself, there's another $10. The cords, you got to buy the fucking video cable, that's another couple bucks. And a memory card, which I'm assuming it's going to have built-in save capability. And the biggest glaring fucking thing that people forget is that this thing is outputting native HDMI. The original PS1 and PS2 never fucking kicked out HD video. So you're getting kind of a free upgrade in a way. I'm going to have to wait and see how well it does, but from my perspective, I think that, like, you have to look at it, you know, and then on top of all of this, Sony has to make money, right? Like, how the fuck are they going to make any money unless they're just giving the fucking things away? I mean, as I said, they could have included, like, 50 games. Like, people are bitching, oh my god, not enough games. Okay, well, how many games do you think that they're going to be able to put on this fucking thing without having to pay licensors again? They're going to have to pay Konami. They're going to have to pay what the hell would it be? Polyphony for Gran Turismo, they'd have to pay Eidos again. People were complaining, oh, why no Tomb Raider? They have to pay Eidos again, or Eidos, or however the fuck you say the company name. And every other company going forward.